Hanna Wildhagen, who specializes in digital phenotyping, oversees the technologies used in KWS's series of tests on the drought tolerance of corn and sugar beet plants in the greenhouse. In putting together the system, the biggest challenges she faced included optimally integrating all technologies into one process and meeting the requirements for flexibility and test frequency.
Measurement accuracy is crucial for the validity and thus for the success of our project. The results that we see must not be random. Therefore, the technologies must enable efficient and objective measures for the drought tolerance of the plants.
The PhenoFactory, a kind of photo box, plays an important role in phenotyping plants.
Phenotyping concerns a plant's external appearance. That means the size and the shape, for example. The human eye can see wavelengths between 400 and 700 nanometers, but the cameras in the PhenoFactory register the smallest changes in ranges that are not accessible to the human eye.
Essential to this are the controlled lighting conditions in the PhenoFactory in order to reduce the influence of sunlight and artificial lighting in the greenhouse on the measurement results. For research into the complex trait of drought tolerance, the plant's water consumption, which can be seen, for example, in the leaves, serves as an important indicator.
We know that the leaf of a plant always dries out from the tip, and this can be very clearly seen in the color spectrum of a plant. We can now use our technology to measure the spectrum anywhere on the plant and analyze them using image processing algorithms.
The researchers use artificial intelligence methods to evaluate the huge amounts of data produced in the greenhouse during the series of tests. They also receive support for their analysis from experienced statistics co-workers.
It is crucial to interpret the results in terms relevant to biology and to draw the right conclusions from them. After all, the knowledge is to be used with a view towards breeding new drought-tolerant varieties.
The project is set up to run over a period of several years. Many options for additional applications of the technologies could emerge at the conclusion of the project.
We have designed a very modular system, so we can very flexibly use it also for other crop types and other breeding objectives in the future.